Dr. Blur, and welcome back to some more Fallcraft, guys. Last episode, we got into some refined storage, and in between episodes, I have done some building and moving things around. Let's take a look-see, shall we? So like I said, I started building this, but I haven't finished it yet, but we don't need it for this episode. I'll do that when I get some more time. I have been building this. So I've moved some of the machines up here. Put these in the walls for decoration. We'll probably never use them again, but they look nice. So I moved all those machines from down here. And what I've done in between episodes, I put a cable in all the way from us refined storage system up there down to here. So in this episode, what I want to do is some more refined storage. In particular, some octo crafting. So let's get on with it, guys. So I've been crafting up some processors, ready. What we need is a pattern grid. So what do we need for this? We need another grid. Just get some smooth stone. Go, the machine casing. Destruction core, and there's this grid. What else do we need for the pattern grid? Advanced processor and a pattern. There's this pattern, crafted up there. Throw them in there. What else we're gonna need? So we're gonna need some more patterns. That'll do for now. I'm also going to need a crafter. So we need some more of these. Machine casing. Another advanced processor. That's the pattern grid. Just wait for these to craft up. It's very slow at the minute. Right, let's put them back in. Wait, what am I doing? That's what I'm supposed to be doing. Here we go, we've got crafter, pattern grid. That's what we do. Throw a pattern grid down here. Put some patterns in. So what I want to do is teach the system how to make processors. So let's start with these, shall we? That one. And that's those made. What we'll do, so I'll just take one of these. Put it here for now. Do though is angle it downwards. I think we need to make a wrench. Just quickly make a wrench. Crescent armor should work. There we go. Those in there. Now if we go back to our system, if I've done everything correctly, there we go, we should be able to craft these. So if I do that, should all work, hopefully. if we've done it right. As you can see, it's crafted it up, but we need to put an importer on the back of this. So that's what we need next. So we need to make a couple more of these. There's the importer. And that should just about be it. Let's test it one more time. Any minute, there we go. Perfect. So, right. That's just the first step. What we need to do next. Automate the printed silicon. So all we have to do, throw this in here. We should be able to craft these. As you can see, we can now craft those. Right. What else do we want? Let's teach it how to craft that. How about, in fact, let's teach it how to make us some more patterns first. Go. Actually, that's not going to work, so we're going to need another crafter first. That right, so you get the basic idea. So I'm just going to set up the rest of these, craft some more patterns, and I'll be right back, guys. So guys, as you can see, I've made some more crafters and I've moved the solderers down here. What I've done is I've split them up, so those, that's the gold one to make the improved processors. This one's on its own because printed silicon is needed for all the other ones. There's the diamond and the advanced processor, and there's the other one. So what I want to do now is I want to auto craft some other pieces. So what we need is another crafter. Which now we can craft all, nearly all the pieces for. So two advanced processors. And that'll happen. And these both need for the basic processors. So where's the basic ones? Two of them. That'll do its thing. All we have to do is wait. What I plan on doing is setting up this. Make some speed upgrades. So we're gonna need some sugar. We're going to need some sugar cane. Let's just leave one in there so we can actually grow some more. What was that? Just a random creeper exploded? Or did something else explode? Huh. No idea. That rain is doing my head in, so let's just quickly sleep. hopefully to stop the rain. It should have had time to process. There's the destruction core, construction core. There we go, there's that. So what we're gonna do here, instead of processing, which is the ones that I use to make these, just a craft, normal crafting one, we're gonna stick upgrade in here, like so. Do that. Just place this here. Put in that, and in the system we should be able to create those. Yep, so we can make one and it'll auto craft that. What we're also gonna do is the patterns, so we can make more patterns. Just throw that in there as well. Make another 5 of them. If we've got enough stuff, yep. That'll craft them up pretty fast, as you can see. So what we're gonna do next, speed upgrade has to be done in the solderer, so we've got to change this to processing. Like that. Let's do it in, so in this one, why not? So 4 upgrade slots, so 16 upgrades we want to create. Speed upgrades. So we need some more glass, some more enriched iron. So what we'll do is we shall stick this one in here so we can auto craft some quartz enriched iron. Throw the sand in here, get some more glass. Throw the quartz enriched iron in there. Now we can auto craft that. Throw the grass in there. Right, let's try again. 16, I'm able to make everything. And I'll be right back as soon as those 16 have crafted up. So guys, as you can see, I've made some more crafters and I've moved those solderers down here. What I've done is I've split them up. So those, that's the gold one to make the improved processors. This one's on its own because printed silicon's needed for all the other ones. There's the diamond and the advanced processor. And there's the other one. So what I want to do now is I want to auto craft some other pieces. So what we need is another crafter. Which now we can craft all, nearly all the pieces for. So 2 advanced processors. And that'll happen. And these both need the basic processors, so where's the basic ones? Two of them, that'll do its thing. All we have to do is wait. What I plan on doing is setting up this, make some speed upgrades, so we're gonna need some sugar. We're gonna need some sugar cane. Let's just leave one in there so we can actually grow some more. What was that? Just a random creeper exploded? Or did something else explode? Huh. No idea. That rain is doing my head in, so let's just quickly sleep. Hopefully to stop the rain. Should have had time to process. There's the destruction core. Construction core. There we go, there's that. So what we're gonna do here, instead of processing, which is the ones that you use to make these, just a craft, normal crafting one, we're gonna stick upgrade in here, like so. Do that. Here, put in that, and in the system we should be able to create those. Yep, so we can make one and it'll auto craft that. What we're also gonna do is the patterns, so we can make more patterns. Just throw that in there as well. Making over 5 of them. If we've got enough stuff, yep. That'll craft them up pretty fast, as you can see. So what we're gonna do next, speed upgrade has to be done in the solderer, so I've got to change this to processing. Like that. Let's do it in, do it in this one, why not? So 4 upgrade slots, so 16 upgrades we want to create. Speed upgrades. So we need some more glass, some more enriched iron. So what we'll do is we shall stick this one in here, so we can auto-craft some quartz-enriched iron. Throw the sand in here, get some more glass. Throw the quartz-enriched iron in there. Now we can auto-craft that. Throw the grass in there. Right, let's try again. 16 to make everything, and I'll be right back as soon as those 16 have crafted up. Welcome back guys, as you can see I've made the speed upgrades. So while the system was creating these I had a few issues, and I don't know what was slowing it down, but for some reason it wasn't crafting the enriched quartz. So what we need next is a crafting monitor, so we can see what's crafting and what's taking too long, just in case there's any more problems. Should be easy enough. Like so. And there we go. As you can see, hasn't found a machine to make these. Why does it think it needs a machine? Let's have a look at the pattern. It should just be a simple craft. Quartz enriched iron. Should just be like that. Right, let's see how it works this time, shall we? Take all that out. it does work. Okay, that's alright. Easy enough. Right. What to do next? Next, I want to make the crafters automated. So what we need first... is a construction cores. Deconstruction core. What else? Machine casing. Right, let's have a look. Throw those in there like so. I always seem to go the wrong direction. We should probably make the actual crafter itself into a pattern. So when we get the crafter manager, we won't have to run down and throw them in all the time. Right, let's see if that works. What are we missing? Ah, silicon. It's not a very good way of making silicon, but you can smelt up never quartz into silicon. Best way to make silicon. You can use the silicon from Ender.io, which as you can see, this material stonework factory can craft it up. But to make one of these, you need some pink slime. I really want to have a go at that, so I think that's what we're going to do for the rest of the episode. Or at least part of it, depending if we've got time. There we go. We can make a crafter. We can just make a big wall of crafters. Fill all of this up. Put as many patterns in as we want. So yeah, okay. Alright, to get the pink slime, what we need is this block here. Mob slaughter factory. To put mobs in front of this. Kills them and drops pink slime. Easy enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get all the pieces for this. And I'll be right back, guys. Welcome back, guys. I've created the mob slaughter factory. Powered it up. Right, so I've also made a golden lasso so we can go move friendly mobs around. So let's go find us victim. Come here, little piggy. Kill 18 melee buckets. Alright, so that's going to take a long time because we need 1,000 melee buckets to spawn a slime. So I guess what we're going to have to do is create a mob farm where we spawn them, breed them, and then kill them. Right then. Okay, but sadly that's the end of this episode. So what I'm going to do in between episodes, finish that off, put a roof on there probably. But next episode, what we need to do, I've had to turn this off as it consumes too much power. So what we're going to have to do next episode is have a look into some more power. Or at least getting some more power to the controller block. Because this little thing does not give us enough power. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye bye.